morning, and I'm part of the Grand River Dam Authority. We implement the program Guard the Grand. And one of the things that we wanted to do for residents and area landowners is kind of show them some of the educational tools that we have available that are either available for you to check out, for us to bring to your school or your event, and talk about non-point source pollution and how things work in a watershed, and even just what is a watershed. And a watershed, if you remember, if you've seen some of the other videos, a watershed is just an area of land where the water falls on and it drains to one location. So in my Augmented Reality Sandbox here, I actually have Grand Lake at one end, and I have the Neosho River and the Spring River. And if you can see, it's already kind of starting to rain up in the Spring River. Nothing's happening in Grand Lake, right? But the water's going to flow downstream, and I'm actually going to start getting more water in the lake. The same thing's going to happen over here if I get it to rain in the Neosho River. The water's going to flow downstream and end up in Grand Lake. So sometimes you might think, why is there so much water coming into Grand Lake and we haven't had any rain? Well, maybe they've had a ton of rain in Kansas, which is actually what happened in 2017. They got a lot of rain up in Kansas, even more than we did, and that had an impact on all the lakes downstream. So the other thing that this sandbox is able to show you is if you look at the different lines in the sandbox and the different colors, it reflects the elevation. So our lakes are always at a lower elevation, our hills are at a higher elevation, so the orange is going to be a higher elevation. And you can kind of see as the water begins to flow, as it starts to rain, it all kind of starts flowing downhill along those contours. And so you might think, well, my pond's over here, my pond is pretty isolated, I'm not going to have an impact on Grand Lake, because maybe it's a pond that you dug and you don't think it ever overflows. But it can, and as it floods, what happens around it is going to flow into our streams and rivers and can have that impact on the lake. The same way over here, if you're living along the shoreline, everything that you do on your land is going to flow into Grand Lake. So it's just kind of a cool tool to be able to use. I can also sort of make it really rain a lot, and you can really kind of see where the water starts to go. And where you think it's going to go one way, it might go another way based on the contours of the land. And that's how we delineate or how we define a watershed area. It's based on the topography of the land and where the water's going to go. And as you can see, I've made it rain, and now I have more water by the color of the water itself. It's gotten darker, right? So I can have a little bit more rain, and I could actually even have a huge rain event that causes a lot of flooding, right? And it's coming from all different areas. So it's just, again, just kind of a cool tool to get to use and explore. So maybe we want to do something slightly different. And I actually have a little helper today who's going to show you guys how you can use the sandbox. Do you want to make a pond or do you want to change something? Okay, well then make a change. Make whatever you want. So the kind of cool thing is, with this, you can sort of, if you want to test what something might happen, like let's say we want to build a new pond, where's the water going to come from it? Or we want to explore, the kids want to explore what happens when you move the lake or when you fill the lake in, where does the water go? That's one of the issues that you see with sedimentation. As she's filling in the lake, we see the water spreading out instead of going down, right? Because now that water has to go somewhere. She's making an island in the lake. So, you know, they can just, kids can explore a lot with this. This is something you as a teacher can check out, or again, you as a resident. The hope is this will be up for display in the Ecosystems and Watershed Management Building beginning in the summer of 2021, so residents can come sort of see how things work. If you have any questions or you want to bring this to your location, feel free to reach out to us at guardthegrand@grva.com, and we look forward to you helping us guard the grand.